Hey guys, it's Chris, and today I want to talk about science and why science is awesome. Since you're on the internet and you're not watching porn or Alex Jones, you're probably already on board with my thesis. Like, this past Monday, a bunch of people photographed these really weird-looking alien invasion clouds over Michigan and Wisconsin. And of course, meteorologists were all like, oh, those? Those are just mammoth clouds. They form when ice crystals fall from a cumulonimbus cloud's anvil. Like it was no big thing, right? Of course, what they didn't explain is the name mammatus comes from the same Latin as mammary, which means yes, some meteorologists officially named those booby clouds because they look like boobs. But more specifically, what I want to talk about today is my very favorite science fact, and that is the fact that we are the first generation of humans to realize that birds are dinosaurs. I'm not saying birds came from dinosaurs, or they're related to dinosaurs, or they evolved from dinosaurs. The scientific consensus today is that dinosaurs never died out as a group, and that birds, all birds, are in fact a living type of dinosaur. Like the way a dog is a type of mammal or Mitch McConnell is a type of turtle, we are surrounded every day by dinosaurs. My childhood pet cockatiel, Caesar, may she rest in peace, was a little dinosaur that lived in a cage in my bedroom and occasionally perched on my finger and ate crackers. Big Bird is a giant yellow dinosaur that teaches children to spell and be polite. Actually, I guess as dinosaurs go, Big Bird's kind of a modest size. Personally, I like to think of Big Bird as an abnormally friendly Brontornis or Terror Bird that somehow survived past the Cenozoic era, like Sesame Street is some kind of landlocked Scottish loch. He does hang out with a mammoth, after all. Speaking of which, I want to address this. Snuffleupagus is pronounced with one F sound. The third syllable is pronounced up, like the Pixar movie. John Green got this wrong in a recent video, and I'm just having a really hard time forgiving him. Like, I think it may be the schism that eventually divides Nerdfighteria forever. Other notable dinosaurs include the Roadrunner, Donald Duck, Tweety Bird, Foghorn Leghorn, and Toucan Sam, whose amazing olfactory powers are quite truthfully attributed by scientists to his dinosaur ancestors. I'm not kidding. There's a link to the Smithsonian article in the description. And if you saw Jurassic Park, you already know that the turkey vulture has one of the strongest senses of smell known to man. Of course, the turkey vulture would make a lousy cereal mascot, because he wouldn't lead children to bowls of brightly colored fruit cereal, but to bowls of decaying carrion. This also means pirates are famous for letting their pet dinosaurs perch on their shoulders. Edgar Allan Poe's poem The Raven is about a man tormented by an intrusive and talkative dinosaur. And the tears of Dumbledore's mythological pet dinosaur were the only antivenom effective against the bite of the basilisk. It means the most common domesticated dinosaur, the chicken, outnumbers humans about 3-to-1 in terms of population. And yes, it means the Great Seal of the United States depicts a dinosaur holding a bunch of arrows in one claw. Your move, Putin. And I guess it means the 38th First Lady of the United States could also be known as Lady Dinosaur Johnson. And a lovely woman she was. So keep this in mind the next time your family sits down at Thanksgiving to carve a roast dinosaur, or you see some old lady throwing breadcrumbs to a flock of dinosaurs. Because this also means dinosaurs have been on Earth continually for about 250 million years, while humans have been around about 200,000, and we've screwed everything up. So thanks for watching, thanks for thinking, and if you do grow up to be a meteorologist, please, try to name more weather patterns after boobs.